Edwin Arlington Robinson told the story poetically of Richard Corey, who, according to his sister-in-law, may well have been about his handsome older brother. But Richard Corey, whenever he went downtown, people from the pavement looked up at him, the people who cursed their bread and went without meat after the great financial crisis of the late 1800s. Because Richard Corey, he had everything. He was admirably schooled in every grace. Everybody wished they were in his place. He was a gentleman from sole to crown. He was clean favored. He was imperially slim. He was always human when he talked, and yet he fluttered pulses when he merely said, "Good morning." He was admirably schooled in every grace. And yet, here's the thing. One calm summer night, Richard Corey went home and put a bullet through his head. What Robinson is telling us there is that be careful about comparing yourself or wishing enviously that you were in somebody else's place, because riches does not guarantee merriment of blissful, euphoric joy. It just doesn't. Because yes, Nietzsche talked about how envy was a good thing because it would make you strive for greatness in ways that you otherwise wouldn't have. Sure, there is that element. But that being said, this poem was written over a century ago, well over 100 years ago, and yet, even though it was well in advance of the advent of social media, I think we would do well to heed this poem, that the person that you think, oh, they're a gentleman from head to crown, they're clean-favored, imperially slimmed, admirably educated in every grace, well-schooled, fluttered pulses when he talks and just says, "Good morning," human when he speaks, he glitters when he walks. He's a gentleman, this Richard Corey. And you think, if only I was him. He was rich, richer than a king. And yet he put a bullet through his head one calm summer night. Bertrand Russell was right when he said, don't be jealous of Napoleon, because Napoleon was in turn jealous of Julius Caesar, and Julius Caesar was in turn jealous of Alexander, and Alexander was in turn jealous of Zeus, and Zeus didn't exist because he already surpassed Achilles, so he had to be jealous of Zeus, and Zeus didn't exist. I mean, even if you get to the top of the proverbial mountain, there will still be somebody of whom you'll be jealous. Like, well, if I was Julius Caesar and I crossed the Rubicon, I would be satisfied. But the fact is, when at leisure in Spain, Julius Caesar was crying when he read an autobiography of Alexander the Great, and he was asked, what's wrong? And Julius Caesar said, Alexander has accomplished such great feats that I have not achieved at his age. Even Julius Caesar felt insufficient. Alexander the Great, this is a mythical story, but I think it speaks to his personality, because it's true that he would walk among the mountains seized by longing. But when he's told by Aristotle, his teacher, that there were planets out there besides his own, like Mars, etc., he said, I haven't even conquered my own world, and yet there's so many other worlds out there to be conquered. There's always more. And while that drive, you can't teach drive, let it fuel you. Yes, that's a good thing. While that drive is a beatific thing, don't let it cause you to be consumed by envy. Because jealousy and comparison, Shakespeare called it the green-eyed monster for a reason. It's evil, and it'll destroy you. Because you may be jealous of Richard Corey, but what you don't know is in a few hours, come twilight, on this calm summer night, Richard Corey's going to put a bullet through his head. Don't compare yourself, because you don't know what's really going on. And the person of whom you're jealous, you don't know what's really going on in their life. Consider that today and find hope in your own story.